I want you to give a huge welcome, because he's not here. He doesn't know that there's just over 1,800 people in the room. Please give a massive welcome to, from Seattle, Mr. Cory Schmitz. Mr. Cory Schmitz, join us. He's here. It's Cory Schmitz. Cory, they are going insane. Can we hear you? Cory, hello?
Can you hear me?
Hey, it's Cory Schmitz. Cory, welcome to Nottingham. How are you?
I'm great. It's really nice outside today.
It's nice outside here? It's like the first day of spring.
It might be here too.
we're so in tune. This is going to go well, I can tell it. Cory, we've been passing around copies of EXP and Controller Relent this evening, but before that, You've got cause for celebration today, haven't you?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It's fine. Don't be modest. It's fine. Tell everybody what's happened yesterday.
The agency I work at in Seattle, it's an ad agency called Wexley, and we do non-traditional advertising campaigns. And we swept an award show last night. We won, I think, 8 awards.
8 awards.
Yeah, and one of them was
Can you hear that? 8 awards.
Yeah, we represented over there. And one of them was for a project that I kind of led for. It was a 8-bit style flash game for a cartoon show on TBS, which is an American channel. I don't know if you guys have it. And it's a game where you pick up dog poop. So I'm glad that won an award.
It sounds noble. So which of the awards are you most proud of the 8 that you won?
Oh, it's totally that one, because I wasn't expecting it to win.
Right. So, Cory, welcome to From the Desk Of. You're at your desk? Are you at your desk? Yeah, there we go. He's at his desk. Cory, one of the things we ask people to do, because we try, this is very much about reducing our carbon footprint, bringing people into Nottingham without really bringing them here, but we really want to know what it's like to be Cory Schmitz, to sit at Cory Schmitz's desk. Can you take us through some of the important objects in your immediate surroundings, please?
Well, I'm a two-desk man, so
oh, really?
I do my day job at my desk downtown at the office, and then I do most of my freelance video game kind of stuff up here on my apartment in Capitol Hill. So I'm on my laptop for work right now. Uh-huh. But, you know, I got my simple setup pretty much.
It's quite tidy, your desk. What's that thing running down the wall there?
That's just a ruler. I have rulers and cutting mats and a uh-huh. scanner and a light box. I keep it pretty tight over here. Nothing too crazy. Mm-hmm. Some magazines and stuff for
really tidy desk. Really tidy.
I don't do a lot of stuff off the computer, so right. Every once in a while I'll sketch something and scan it in, but other than that, not too much painting or anything like that. So right. I don't need that much.
What's on your left hand side?
My left hand side, I have here. I'll just unplug for a second.
All right, that's fine.
I have my video game stuff.
Yeah.
And yeah. I have my cool Super Brothers poster.
Rob? Yeah, we got a massive Super Brothers fan here this evening. You just heard.
Oh,
Rob,
really?
With that one round of applause you heard there, that was him.
He's the Super Brothers is the coolest dude ever. I just hung out with him at GDC. He's awesome.
Right.
And I got my shelf.
What are those things? This is a lot of books, a lot of... What are we seeing there? We've got...
I got games and...
Are they games, DVDs? I can't really... Are they games, DVDs? What have we got there? History of Violence? Yeah. What's it? Beta? Oh, yeah. What are you playing at the moment?
I'm playing Bulletstorm and Sword and Sorcery. Pokemon. Ghost Trick.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah, lots of games right now, actually. I'm kind of stressing out about it because I'm getting 3DS on Sunday.
You haven't got one yet?
No, it's not out here yet.
Oh, really?
You guys got it first.
Yeah, it's all right.
It's like the first time that's ever happened.
Okay. I mean, yeah, no, it's brilliant. It's the single best. It's the peak of human communication. In the 21st century so far. Huh? Have a what? Do I have a what? 3DS.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I do actually. It's all right.
Ah.
Yeah, it's good. It's like what launch titles are you getting? Anything? I mean.
I'm actually gonna get Street Fighter and Ghost Recon. I think.
You're not gonna get Pilot Wings.
Oh, and yes, I'm getting Pilot Wings.
Yeah, you
as
won't
well.
Get Pilot Wings.
Those are the three.
Street Fighter's okay, but yeah? It's Pilot Wings that you want. Sorry, so there's a whole room of people. There's a whole room of people here.
I'll take your word for it.
Well, I'm just saying. I'm just trying to help. So, Cory, can you tell us a little bit about the magazine? Can you tell us a little bit about the Kickstarter project that got going? Because I guess that's one of the things that you're most known for, right?
I suppose so. Yeah. So it started last year, actually. I was a senior at art school here in Seattle, and when it came time to pick a thesis, we do a show at my school for the seniors. So my thesis, of course, I wanted to do something about video games, and I love magazines, so it seemed like a perfect fit. So that's how EXP was started, and I made that in a few months, and then had a little show at school about it. And then before it was completely finished, I'd gotten a ton of emails about people wanting to order it, which is crazy because I didn't even think it would get any attention because I thought it was just going to be a school project. So that was awesome. So I decided to start a Kickstarter so I could fund printing and a sequel to it, basically, which is the controller. And so I didn't do as much research as I probably should have because I went way over budget. But it was a great experience. It was cool to see everyone excited about something I was making right out of school. I was working full-time when I made it, though, so lots of late nights, really busy, kind of stressful with the deadlines. Let's see. But yeah, I mean, it was very, very fun. I definitely like the second one better, I think, because of the... It's more of a collaboration, I'd say.
Right. So, and you reached your Kickstarter total really quickly, right?
Yeah, I did. I mean, it made me wish that I'd asked for more.
Do you have to give it back if it goes over the...
No, you get to keep whatever it goes over.
All right. That's all right, then.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, yeah. Yeah, I think I reached my total in like a few days and I had set it to be for a month, so that was very exciting.
Right, fantastic. So, look, two things. Can you tell us about how the collaboration with the Super Brothers came about, and what you've been working on with them?
Yeah, it's a pretty small scale thing, but it's very fun. I met Craig just a couple weeks ago at who's Super Brothers. I met him a couple weeks ago at GDC, and we kind of got to talking a bit before then on Twitter and stuff about the LP release of the soundtrack. And he'd already designed the packaging for it, but he asked me to do a print for the inside. And so I made it like the day after I got back from GDC, because I was really excited. And also, that was like the deadline. I was like, come back, design it real quick, and then send it off. But I'm really happy with it turned out. So that was pretty sweet.
So the game just shipped over here yesterday, was it, Rob? Yesterday. Did it ship in the States yesterday, too? I think
I think it shipped on Wednesday here. I'm not sure, though. I think it might have been the same time everywhere. I can't remember.
Okay. Is the soundtrack album out at the same time?
That comes out at the end of next month, I believe.
All right.
So just in time for the iPhone release.
But it's doing an iPhone release.
I think they're putting out iPhone in April.
All right, fantastic. Because it's doing really well over here. It's number...
It's doing crazy good. I think it's in second place on the App Store right now.
Yeah.
I'm really happy for them, Cappy.
That's fantastic.
They must be so excited right now.
Yeah.
They're the nicest people ever, too.
Did you get a royalty? I mean, is it good news for you that it's number two on the App Store? Are you going to
Well, no, I don't have anything to do with the actual place? Game. So
I'm not saying it's small.
I wish.
You never know, right? So what are you working on? You're going to show us some of the things you're working on now. You're going to share your screen. Can you do that?
Okay,
we've not done this before. This is new ground.
I'll show you guys the print I made for the LP.
Great.
Did it work?
Almost. If you hear a cheer, it means it's worked. It's very quiet. Hang on, stand by. It's coming. I can tell it's going to work. Hey! I mean, technically that was a cheer, right? All right.
So this is the print. This is actually the first time anyone's seen this, I think. But this is the print for the LP. And so it's a two-color offset print. Basically, they had given me the game a couple weeks before it came out and had me play through it and interpret it my own way. So this is what came out about that. So I don't know if you guys have all played it yet, but there's sheep in it.
How many people have played, apart from Rob? 2, 3. I mean, everyone's going to go home and play it.
You have to.
That's what you have to take away from this.
It's the best game.
Yeah, that's very sick. So any questions from the audience for Cory? Rob, I can't believe you don't have a question. Sorry? Question from the floor. What do you think of the game?
Sorcery?
Yeah.
When they gave it to me for the early build of it, it was like the happiest day of my life. Not really, but it's an amazing game.
You don't have like kids, so you're not married or anything.
No, yeah. I haven't had too much life experience yet.
That's good. But you should. I mean,
no, it's so incredible. I love the game. I think it's one of the most beautiful games I've ever played before, and I like it. It's the artwork, the music, the story. It's just so much different than most games.
Any more questions from the floor for Cory? Rob's. The other Rob has got a question. Hang on. Do you want to come out the front, Rob? Because he's going to be sick of looking at me. Come out the front.
Oh, really?
Yeah. He's going to come and so you can see somebody else. He's just making his way. It's a huge auditorium we're in here. We could take a few moments, Cory, if you just bear with us. He's just fighting his way. Yeah, just fighting past security now. It's Rob. He's here to ask you a question, sir.
Show up the crowd. Hey, man.
Oh, sorry. Obviously, you did a kind of print publication. Do you think it's sad that print is kind of on the decline? That, you know, people aren't taking the time to do print magazines, things like that, with the internet and the future of the internet?
Yeah, it's a bummer. I think there will always be at least a niche there for it. Luckily, when I made my magazines, I wasn't hoping to make any profit. It was more of just a labor of love. And so as long as people continue that to have passion for print publications, I think it will be okay. And that way, you know, it'll only be people that are really passionate about it. And that's all I really care about, too, is, you know, just seeing all the best artwork and articles that magazines have. So. And I really actually like iPad magazines. I have a few of them that I subscribe to, like Post and Wired. It's really cool. I'd hope to do something like that eventually, too.
So video game magazines are new graphic novels?
Yeah, I mean, that would be awesome. I hope so. I hope they can weed it out so it's just the people that are really passionate about making beautiful magazines. I really like Amusement magazine in France. Have you guys seen that?
No.
It's really, 1 second.
He's gone.
I think he'll come back.
It's been a pleasure.
No, he's back.
This magazine. This is the best. They have all, this is a video game magazine. And it's beautiful. They had 50 pages about Tron in the last one.
What a waste of time.
Yeah.
Shall I go now?
Any more questions?
I think I'm done.
All right. Any more?
Just the death of Prince. That's all I wanted to speak.
No, it's pretty much all over. Any more questions for Cory? Lee, surely you have a question. Lee might have a question. Lee, with whom you're familiar. Lee.
Hello. I can't remember who it was, but I saw on your Twitter that someone that we probably all know was wearing your T-shirt, which I'm wearing now. It's a Zelda Triforce Wisdom Power.
Oh, yeah.
I can't remember who it was. Who was it that was wearing it? And kind of how does it feel?
That was Richard from Naughty Dog.
Richard Lamasa.
Oops, sorry.
Yeah, okay.
Yes.
Richard from Naughty Dog. And I guess, how does it feel that people are kind of wearing your designs and people are kind of slowly recognizing your work and your contribution to video game culture?
It's kind of crazy. I mean, I saw a bunch of people wearing my shirts at GDC, and it's just always kind of surprising. I want to just go up to them and hug them.
We could do like a cyber hug now. I think I should leave now. thanks.
I'm sorry I violated you.
That's the most intimate thing that's ever happened certainly at GameCityNights, possibly in this building. Richard, someone should try and get Naughty Dog to come to the festival.
He totally would do it. He's the best.
Yeah, no, I wonder if he'll come. One more question from... Oh, two more questions. Do you want to go first, Rob? Yeah, I mean, you kind of know Rob already. Rob is the... Is a third of the people in the room who have bought Swords and Sorcery, but Rob?
Hello.
Hey, man.
All right, mate. That looks amazing as well. Sheep. It's good.
Sheep. Yeah, right?
Sheep and the swords, field. You can't go wrong. Just a question. And I know it's a difficult question, put you on the spot. What's your favorite game?
Ever?
Ever. Best game ever.
Oh man, that's killer!
I know it is. Yeah, I'm a real bastard. Sorry.
Can I do like three?
You can do three. That's great.
I think I'd say Eco is definitely one of them.
Right. Okay. Yeah.
I'd say Eco. I'd say.
We call it Echo. But...
Oh really?
Yeah, we're English. It's all right.
Eco.
Ignore us. We don't know how to pronounce anything.
I'm looking at my shelf right now. I gotta say, Katamari.
Katamari, yes, yeah. Have you been to Game City? You ought to meet Kaita, comes to Game City quite a lot. Guy made Katamari.
I know, I really want to meet him. I'm friends with him on Facebook.
I've cleaned up his sick.
Yeah. I won't repeat that. I will. Ian's cleaned up his sick. There you go. You're not a real friend of Kaito until you've cleaned his sick. So third, we got to Echo or Eco. We got Katamari. What was the third? Sorry.
The thing is I really like all the new indie games and stuff, but they haven't had time to sink in for me.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm sure that some of these games like Machinarium and Sword and Sorcery and Flower.
Is that coincidence? We have the guy who made Machinarium here tonight.
Oh, yeah.
Come and say hello.
No, I'm so excited about that.
In fact, if that's one of your favorite games, then here is the guy who made that game.
Hello.
Oh, hey.
Nice to meet you.
I think you're making a game together next, aren't you? I think that's...
Oh, yeah.
Oh, sure.
Game City, building bridges.
Let's do it.
So is that your third favorite game? You have to say
there's
yes.
There's so many. I'm a huge Metal Gear Solid fan, too. Oh. So any of those.
Yes. Fantastic. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, man.
Any more questions? Mira, do you have a question? Mira, come. Well, he can't hear you if you stood at the back. She's finding her way through the throng. There's another mic.
I just wanted to ask when Cory is going to come to Game City and show his work and do some cool things with us.
You coming this October?
When's that? October?
You're going to come this... Hey, why don't you do... I'll tell you what we nearly did last year. We nearly did a thing with... what's her name?
The woman who just Level Up. The zine?
Rainer, with Rainer Lee. So we nearly did a thing where she was going to make a zine in a week of the festival.
That sounds awesome.
Yeah, why don't you come and do that?
I will do that.
Wait, Cory Schmitz is coming to Game City 6 this year. He's going to come and make a zine with us.
Is that on a weekend or is it a whole week?
Have you got the dates, yeah? It's last week in October.
October?
Yeah, last week in October. You all right for that?
It might be in Chicago.
25th to the 29th this week. You all right?
It might be in Chicago, but I'm not sure.
Well, check it now.
Game City.
What do you think?
Let me find my itinerary real quick. Hold on.
All right. It's fine. We'll just fill while you check your diary. What are you doing in Chicago anyway?
Oh, that's in September.
So Chicago's in September. So you're coming to Game City?
If I can afford it, I will come.
We'll sort you out. Someone will sponsor the making a zine, I'm sure. That's fantastic news. So all these people will be able to meet you in this city in October.
I've never left North America before. I'm scared.
You love Nottingham. Nottingham is a wonderful sample of what England is about. Jakob's coming back as well.
All right.
Yeah, no, it's going to be fantastic. You should come. That's brilliant news. You're coming. Excellent.
I'll ask my boss on Monday.
Huh?
I'll ask my boss if I can take a week off.
How many weeks off do you get a year?
Two.
A year? Really?
Thanks.
Cory.
America's tough.
It sounds tough. All right, Cory Schmitz, thank you so much for joining us this evening. They all think you're brilliant. They're all looking forward to seeing you this October.
Hopefully.
This is quite an awkward moment where we have to kind of quit Skype because we need to get the laptop over, but I'll email you later and we'll all apologize for suddenly stopping this conversation really abruptly.
You guys are awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Cory Schmitz, it's him again. He's still there. Thank you. Goodbye.
Bye. I'm going
to
quit.
Can we go back to the... My goodness. That was exciting. He's coming here to make a magazine this October. He quits. That's good news.